So Dylan Larkin, the only player among these men who has won before this competition. So some experience, Boosh, dealing with this.
He has to be the favorite in this event.
He is the betting favorite early on.
But I will say, keep an eye on Chandler Stephenson. That guy can fly.
He's got wheels.
I think he's a guy that could challenge Larkin in this event.
Larkin is the record holder. Of course, Armark Messier was a fastest skater competitor back in 1990. That great year for Mess, won MVP, won the Cup. So Larkin's going to go back for some perhaps last-minute hydration. And going first, I mean, when you think fast skaters, you think Cale Makar, who's chosen to go counterclockwise. There is some strategy there.
Cale Makar could skate backwards.
True.
And compete.
Driver 8, take a break. All wearing the reverse retros tonight.
Yeah, love it.
For the skills competition.
Love it.
So one of the best skaters on planet Earth. Cale Makar will begin the 2023 All-Star Skills. Grew up in Western Canada and, of course, now a member of the Stanley Cup champion. Colorado Avalanche, turn number one.
Oh,
and Makar goes down, and he will be out.
Now he's got to finish the clock of time, but that's a bummer.
So again, all the skaters will go. We'll take the two fastest times and do the final later in the evening.
Yeah, you know, when he's coming around, even that first turn, he stumbled a hair coming out of the first turn, and then it's such a bummer when that happens. They don't get a redo as they changed that rule a couple years ago. And again, as you guys said, one of the best skaters in the league, so too bad.
So down goes Makar. Up next, Kevin Fiala. They'll go clockwise. Kirill Kaprizov was supposed to be in this competition. Fiala is a late replacement, the LA Kings forward.
Rocking a tremendous mustache right now.
That lip sweater is majestic. Here he comes. See if he can keep his edges here. Oh, he looks good early.
Yeah, picking up speed with the turns, with the crossovers.
Born in Switzerland. Here he comes. Good finish, 13.997. Pat Maroon with us of the Tampa Bay Lightning. What do you think, Patty? How'd he look?
Oh, this is great. Fiala was faster. Felt bad there for Makar there. He toe picks, and I'm just glad he's all right. I'm sure these guys don't want to get hurt, but that was a pretty fast. What is that, 13.9? So
yeah.
That's going to be hard to beat.
Oh, it's the time to beat for now. And we'll see what Andrei Svechnikov can bring, the Carolina Hurricane winger. What a wagon this guy is, a thoroughbred on skates.
Yep, big man, powerful. Get through that turn, and then you can let the long strides take over once you get between the blue lines.
He'll go clockwise as well, so here he comes. The Russian can really wheel.
There you go.
See if he can beat Fiala's time. He does.
Yeah.
The 22-year-old is the leader in the clubhouse now. AJ, how's he looking? He's right in front of you right now.
Yeah, I told you, guys, I got a great seat down here. He was sort of dragging his stick behind him a little bit, but I know we got Pat Maroon off to my right. Pat, which direction would you go for next year when you're in this competition? Would you go clockwise or counterclockwise?
I would go clockwise, I think, but I don't think you guys will ever see me in the fastest skate event, I'll tell you that.
How about if it's downhill?
Yeah, if it's downhill and
on a sled?
And a sled, and I'll be just fine. But this has been fun. These guys are fast skaters.
Matty Beniers was supposed to be part of All-Star Weekend. He got injured, so this was his replacement, Chandler Stephenson. And he can really wheel.
He can scoop. This guy can skate. And I would say keep an eye on him to challenge with Larkin.
Grew up in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Vegas Golden Knight, here he is, gliding along, efficient.
Oh.
So that will likely not hold up. So this is good news for Svechnikov. Remember, two will move on. The final will be later. Normally, we crown a champion right now at this moment. We're going to save it for later. So here comes Larkin. Again, the odds-on favorite. He's got his eyes on Andrei Svechnikov, the UFA-to-be, the captain of the Red Wings, will go counterclockwise. The Michigan kid, former Michigan Wolverine. He is looking to go now, and he knows what he has to do. Years old. Here he goes. Big, powerful strides. He's a powerful 200-foot player.
Here he goes. Where he can pick it up right here.
Here we go. Can he beat Svechnikov?
Oh.
No.
Whoa.
So that means Stevenson is still alive. Fiala, I'm sorry. Now it's Fiala and Svechnikov. And so...
What a surprise.
What a final. We have... The Hurricane and the King. Fiala looks stunned.
That was right.
So reintroducing the two finalists to the crowd here in Sunrise, Kevin Fiala and Andrei Svechnikov. How about that King sweater? I just...
Yeah, love that. I love
just
the Minnesota
beautiful.
Wild paying homage to the old Minnesota North Star jerseys. Love that. I love the retros.
And Fiala replaced the wearer of said Wild jersey, Kirill Kaprizov. So... Clockwise for Kevin Fiala. He had the slower time of the two to reach the final, so he'll skate first, so Svechnikov will know what time he has to beat. A little pressure on Fiala. You can't afford to fall because then Svechnikov can just go for a stroll. Here goes Fiala. Good start. Quick, choppy strides. Crossover in full effect. See how aggressive the crossovers are. Now, see, this time he glides. Now he'll try to finish hard.
A little slower than his preliminary time.
Just a little bit. He was 13.9.
Yep.
Now he's 14.1.
That's time off in the locker room, and you cool off a little bit.
Yep.
But I also think you guys were talking about it. He's a little conservative.
Yeah.
Because if he does blow a tire in this, he goes down. He makes the path pretty easy for Svechnikov. So
he went full crossover the first time, but the second time he didn't.
That first turn, it looked like he almost took it too narrowly and almost hit the cone.
Looks like his weight's a little bit back on those crossovers the second time around.
So Svechnikov was 13.7. He can afford to go a little slower and still win. Obviously, any time in the 13s will mean he's the champion. Nice, big, powerful crossovers.
It's over.
Let's see if he does it again.
He leads by...
Oh, here he goes. Finish it off. Oh, he's got it. There's your winner.
Yeah.
Good call, Boosh. The Carolina Hurricanes have an outstanding season this year. They're in first place, and one of the reasons why is that superstar, Andrei Svechnikov.
Smoother in the turns, and when he gets in the straightaway, much more powerful. Get a look at him right here. This is just you can see once he starts crossing over, he's getting faster as he turns.
Look.
Beautiful shot there on his edges. He beat his time from the first round.
And as I mentioned, too, while he was going, big smile on his face as he came down in front of the benches, too, getting a little harassed by the players.
Well, congrats on that. The Roddy Brind'Amour conditioning program coming into play here.
Yeah, and actually, there's a little story. We went to the break right now, and he tell in the locker room, we got to hit the gym. Don't forget about that. So it's awesome, and I'm kind of super excited to win this.
What did you think? What was your strategy there in the final?
Yeah, I mean, there wasn't really strategy, to be honest. I just tried to go fast as I can.
Well, you certainly did that. You were absolutely flying, and we know you're jacked already playing for the Canes, but congrats. Enjoy it.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Back to you, Bucci.
Good stuff, Weeksy. Carolina Hurricanes and Andrei Svechnikov have the Stanley Cup on their minds. Still out of breath, even after... A couple of minutes from the fastest. Look at him. He's just loving life.
He's smiling, but he's holding his breath there. That's why he's out of breath.
Let's meet your All-Star goalies. For the Central Division, from the Nashville Predators, Juuse Saros. And from the Winnipeg Jets, Connor Hellebuyck. For the Pacific Division, from the Edmonton Oilers, Stuart Skinner. And from the Vegas Golden Knights, Logan Thompson. For the Metropolitan Division, from the New York Islanders, Ilya Sorokin. And from the New York Rangers, Igor Shesterkin. from the Atlantic Division, from the Boston Bruins, Linus Ullmark. And from the Tampa Bay Lightning, Andre Vasilevsky.
Teaming up. So Stuart Skinner, new daddy. He and his wife just had a baby. The Edmonton Oiler goaltender. So he's trying to get points by either scoring, hitting the net. He must do either. He gets nothing.
Ew.
All right.
2 points.
So 2 points. And that means it'll be a 2-on-0. Here comes Elias Pettersson. Is it in?
No.
It's not in.
Tried to slip that five hole. Pettersson did, but.
So 2 points for each side.
Here the feed, and yeah, you can see he's just trying to sneak it right under the pad. But Hellebuck, who was deep in his net, was able to get that pad down quickly.
All right, so don't forget, Skinner and Hellebuck are not friends here. Skinner's trying to get points for his team, and he wants a 3-on-0 against Hellebuck. That looks like he pulled that one badly.
But that's okay, because I would rather that than flub it down the ice.
Oh, no! Yo, ding dong, yo. Hellebuck gets help from the post, and he gives it a little bit of a tap. Rebecca with a nasty snipe.
That left-hand shot coming down the off wing. And
listen. Oh!
Wow, she ripped it.
Here's our Hillary Knight looking on. Here. Hillary will rim it around to Skinner. He'll try again. Looking for a three-pointer.
Looks good.
Center cut. Board chop! Three on oh. Hillary, Dreisaitl, and Kevin Fiala. Come on, Hillary, finish! No! Hellebuck with the save.
Sometimes with a 3-on-0, there's too many cooks in the kitchen.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Who's taking the shot?
Let's go. We need leadership. How's it look down there, AJ Malesko?
It's pretty exciting, but everybody's up on their feet, so, you know, around where I am, so I got to get on my tiptoes to try to see it. But, you know, this is the type of thing, Boosh, you were talking about. We got weeks of you guys, goalies. Sort of, I feel like this would be your dream. Get out there, get the puck on your stick, try to get it the length of the ice. Might be the challenge, right?
I'm sure Hillary's not used to a monster like Connor Hellebuck in that.
That's true.
It's hard to see any twine. All right, Skinner again. Here he goes. Could he do it again?
No. Nope.
Oh, that one's a little left, nope. And he missed. That's a nothing. That's a zilch. So no points on that attempt. So here we go. Connor McDavid. Oh!
Ooh!
Boy, he was trying, too. That was like 97% effort.
Yeah, he thought he had him. Great save there by Connor Hellebuck. The Michigander, that big left pad, big flipper.
Yeah, played college hockey at UMass Lowell.
Uh-huh.
Scoring seems to be at a minimum here.
Oh, I just couldn't lift that quick enough.
How good is that?
Mm.
I'll tell you what, if you're going to miss the net and have a single solo breakaway, McDavid's the guy you want to have, right?
That's right.
Absolutely. All four saves for Hellebuck. 4 for 4. So now Nazem Kadri would throw it to Skinner.
He's got this one.
Think so?
Yeah.
Oh, you think he pulled it again?
He's got this one.
No.
Oh! Yeah, he healed it. He healed that one.
Never take betting tips from Weeksy.
So it's Kadri versus Hellebuck. Oh, he's dancing, and he backhands it over the net.
Nice move, though, by Naz.
Hellebuck having a strong year. 9.23 save percentage for the surprising Winnipeg Jets.
I'll tell you what, he's right up there in the Vezina conversation right now for me. Connor Hellebuck's been amazing up in Winnipeg.
So now the Pacific goalie's in net, and the Central Division goalie will shoot, Boosh. Oh.
Oh. Oh, that's going to fade off.
Yeah.
Remember, there's a little bit of, like, it cuts a little bit, right?
Crown, right? A little crownage.
Yeah.
Seth Jones of the Blackhawks. Oh, I thought he was going to keep going forehand. I think he had him.
Yeah, I think he was trying to go five hole there. Good answer by Thompson. As Weeksy said, one of the best stories in the NHL this year is Logan Thompson. I mean, what he's been able to do from where he started to where he is tonight. Incredible story. Seth Jones with the long reach. He's trying to put it five hole, but that stick of Thompson was right there to knock it away.
All right, Robertson guaranteed a goal.
He did.
Here's the look at our
Mr. Instant Offense
helmet cam.
And here's the thing, too. a how-to guide for no training camp, no preseason, new contract, and come and dominate.
Attempt number two for Saros.
Oh, that's got nice sauce on it.
He's well wide. So here we go. Jason Robertson guaranteed a goal for you, Weeksy.
He's got it. California born, he's got it.
There he comes. Back it up, kid.
No. Oh!
That glove's on the wrong hand.
That's what messed him up.
That's supposed to be blocker.
It is. Advantage southpaw, though.
Advantage goalies in this. They're dominating.
Yeah. Of course, AJ. Why are you surprised?
She sounds surprised, Boosh. Did you hear that? I just came down here to jam her up in the box, too. I'm like, what's going on?
7-for-7.
You played D.
I was not out here for any of these competitions, that's for sure. I would not have been chosen.
Vladdy Tarasenko is a lethal goal scorer, too.
Yeah, he will dump it in.
Yep.
Saros can just hit the net at least. He'll give his squad a 2-0.
Nice sauce.
He's going to pull that one as well.
Yeah. Nice sauce, though. That's
so
nice
here we go.
Rotation.
Tarasenko shoots it wide.
Healed that wide.
See the difference between Thompson and Hellebuck and their styles on the breakaways? Thompson's out. Hellebuck was back. Hellebuck's so big. Just two different styles, both.
Yeah.
Very effective, though, so far.
Absolutely, Boosh. Good call by you.
Kirill Kaprizov is full of magic. Number 97 of the Minnesota Wild.
Kirill the Thrill.
He'll try to score on
Kirill the Thrill.
25-year-old Logan Thompson. Saros. Yussi, you got to step up here, kid. This has a chance.
There it is!
Oh, winner, winner, chicken parm dinner. There we go.
A little lost beat sauce.
3-0.
Another post. And she went for it, too. She went for it. She did. Yussi Saros with the accuracy. Nice to see. Laced that one. Dead center, too. Fans probably partying back in Nashville. They're always partying
AJ,
Nashville.
These women are sniping.
Not quite. Inches. Game of inches, right? They're hitting those pipes.
Saros likes that. Yes.
As he should.
All goalies want to score.
Absolutely.
Nathan McKinnon. Lil Mac.
Oh, yeah. Lil Mac. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. That's what PK said.
PK dubbed him Lil Mac. Yeah. That's the nickname he chose. Yeah, PK Lil. Gave him three options. So here's Saros. See if he can just keep that same form.
Yep.
Do it again.
Some nice loss.
He's got a chance. It's going to hit the net. It's
going to
hit the net. Okay, so.
Oh.
Two. Gets himself 2 points and a 2-on-0. Teammates, McCarr, McKinnon. McCarr, McKinnon. Oh, iron unkind again. Is it in? Back
iron
bar,
unkind.
We're saying. No, it's back bar goal.
Yeah.
That was it.
That was it.
So finally, someone has scored, that and of course, it's one of the best in the game, Nathan McKinnon.
Yeah, leave it to him.
Saros started slow.
Yep.
Found his groove.
Yeah, oh, that's just teasing you all. That's all. He's playing coy.
Ooh, oh, yeah, what a shot
absolutely.
That is, huh?
He's playing coy, that's all.
What a shot, posting in.
Took 10 tries to beat one of these NHL goalies. Matthew Tkachuk, another fan favorite. First year here in Florida. He'll rim it around to Linus Allmark.
Woo, hammering it down.
Let's see what kind of offensive game Linus had. Oh, that was a nice wrist shot. Oh, just wide. He had a lot on that, though. So here we go. Tkachuk against Shesterkin. Oh, showed backhand the whole time, then went forehand late.
Yeah, tried to change the angle right, backhand to forehand, move that puck about 3 feet, but just Sturk and patient.
1 point for every save, don't forget.
Here, watch, he goes backhand, forehand right there. That's about 3-4 feet, but that blocker hand was right there for Sturk and a good patient save.
His brother Brady now is next. He'll slowly dump it to Allmark, much more sensitive. Linus has real good sauce.
Yep, that's
He's
a nice
got
heat.
Excellent sauce. Oh. All right, that's good enough, though. So a 2-on-0. Larkin and Tkachuk. A couple of American kids. Oh, nice late pass. He tried to slide it back 5-hole, huh?
He did. I think Tkachuk was surprised that it came back to him, and Shesterkin read it perfectly, and Tkachuk had absolutely nowhere to go but maybe 5-hole.
Yeah, tried to get frisky. Shesterkin wasn't having it. Nice stop there by Igor Shesterkin.
See the read here. You know, as a goaltender, right, Weetzy, you're anticipating that there's going to be one more pass.
Absolutely.
Like you're on top.
100%. They're loving the extra pass. That's well read there by you, Boosh.
Barkov will dump it into Allmark. Really impressed with Allmark. I didn't realize he had that much power in his goalie wrist shot, but this one's wide.
Yeah, that's icing.
So it's Barkov against last year's Vezina Trophy winner, Igor Shesterkin. He's got to score. Oh, did he toe that?
Toe. Yeah. Toey.
Toey low bacon,
yeah,
Weeksy?
Yeah, that was a toey.
Toed
you see that
sprocket.
One, AJ?
I saw it. I actually could see that from here. I got a good angle on it.
You got some good pepper on it, too.
Yeah, well, it's just circuit.
We got to see this toey low bacon again.
Yes, yes.
Look at this. Hello.
Backwards, too, maybe.
That's spicy.
So Shesterkin last year, third in the MVP voting.
Yep. Reigning Vezina Trophy winner.
And won his first Vezina of his young career. The 27-year-old Russian is off and running in his career. So Nick Suzuki, the captain of the Canadians, is the next dump-in. He'll dump it to
Some nice loft on it.
Oh, so now we have a 2-on-0.
Ooh.
Rasmus Dahlin and Nick Suzuki.
Oh,
Dahlin. Oh
my. See, goodness. There's the extra. There's the extra one you're talking about, Booth.
Rasmus a bit wobbly with the mittens there.
Right off the start, huh? What a gift for Igor.
He'll take it. His groins say thank you, too. His groins say thank you.
I'm a little surprised that Shesterkin was not the one shooting for how good he can fire the puck.
True.
He's one of the best. He's maybe the best stretch passer among goalies in the NHL right now. He'll go tape to tape from 150 feet. But Allmark definitely has. Oh, slap shot!
Slapper, no!
Oh, that would have been unbelievable if that went in.
Love it.
That's impressive. Hey, I can't tell you how hard that is to do with a goalie stick. That's super impressive.
Nurse versus Shesterkin! Oh, the Forsberg!
Sarah Nurse is dirty. She's so good.
Sarah Nurse.
Ice cold as she looks into the camera, too.
Pulls off the postage
Sarah
stamp
Nurse
move.
Is so good.
The Forsberg.
The Forsbergian.
Forsbergian.
Wow.
No celebration either. She just goes down.
Cold as ice.
Absolutely. Booch, can you hear us up here?
Oh, yes.
Booch, you got us?
Gotcha.
We got a really good guest down here, the great Roberto Luongo, who was recently enshrined in Hall of Fame. Lou, how you doing?
Doing good. I'm trying to rest up the groins here, a little tight.
You look like yourself, bro. You look like you can still go.
This is my house. This is my home right here.
That's right. You helped build this. That's true.
The crease is my home.
That a boy.
Roberto Luongo, 489 career wins. Yep. Patty Maroon, who do you have?
What's going on here, guys? I have Eric Carlson here, but I got to tell you what here. I'm freezing down here. I'm not used to this. I'm used to the gear. But Eric, coming here, All-Star game, multiple. What's the coolest experience?
No, I mean, it's fun. You know, it's a lot of standing around on a day like this, but you can see the people around you that is enjoying it, and, you know, especially the guys with kids. You know, I got my own now, so I think that's pretty cool and special. So, you know, as much as we complain about certain things, we still, you know, enjoy the excitement that it brings to a lot of people.
Yeah, absolutely. So Eric went to Disney World. He said he's still exhausted from it. How was it? How's the family? It looks like your daughter was sitting on your lap here ready to fall asleep.
It was good. It was need a vacation from the vacation. A lot of walking. Blew my back out the first day carrying kids, but that's pretty standard for everybody that has kids. You know that. And, you know, same there. It's just fun. It's all for the kids, right?
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Take it down one more button, Patty, then you'll really get cold, brother. All right. Sidney Crosby failed to score on Andrei Vasilevsky. Sorokin pulls that wide, so it's Ovechkin one-on-one.
Yep.
Here comes Ovi. Going after Gretzky's record. And going after Vasilevsky. He ripped that one.
He ripped that, too. He
got
totally
a piece
did.
Of it. Blocker?
Maybe just a whisker, Fouche. Just a whisker.
Over
just
here with Sergei. Yeah. There's little Sergei Ovechkin.
Yeah,
he wants to play.
Absolutely. He's disappointed in Dad for missing there. He turned his back on him. Did you see that?
And Ovi, shame.
Ovi told me he's a full lefty, left-hand shot, Ovi Jr. He's trying to get him to shoot right, but he loves shooting left.
During warm-up, his dad kept trying to get him to take pictures with people, and he kept whipping around. He just wanted to skate.
Ilya Sorokin.
Off speed.
Playing the right to left break.
Soft third.
All right, here comes Alex Carpenter.
That was soft serve.
She's got plenty of game. She got one of those big Draisaitl boat oar sticks. Oh, rips it wide. Sorokin 0 for 3. just trying to hit some plywood at this point.
I have not been impressed with his shooting abilities. Oh. I was shocked that they went from Shesterkin to make the saves. Hopefully he can find his groove here.
Only takes one.
Hey, Bucci.
Yo.
Time in Boston. We got Dave Pastrnak down here. Pastrnak, what's the word?
What's the word? I mean, so far, I know how hard it is. You know, a little credit to this goal is hitting the net even because, you know, personally, I have a tough time to hit it from the full ice.
You don't have any tough time hitting the net. Who are you kidding?
Johnny Hockey. Smell the glove.
Smell the leather.
Pasta was on the golf course all day today, so he might be a little fried.
Yeah, he's got a nice tan on right now, though.
Yeah, tell him how his golf game was. First glove save.
Yeah, he just said he was golfing. Bucci was saying, yeah, exactly. He's like, I've been golfing the last 2 days. Yeah. So the mitts should be good.
Here comes Panarin now. So this will be Russian on Russian. Panarin to the Rangers will dump it in to his rival. Hard dump in. Trying to rattle him. All right, here we go.
Oh, he went for it.
No, my goodness. Foul ball, Weeksy.
No, but there's elevation, though. There's at least elevation.
Here's Panarin. Breadman. Oh, nothing.
Why does it strike me that Vasilevsky is the type of guy that just gets so fired up for this? Like, he don't want to get beat at any point in his life.
Down.
This real game, this, he wants to win everything. The big cat shuts the door there.
So central, and oh, look at that, arms in his air. Connor Hellebuck, truly excited.
All right, what's going
on?
Who
do you got, Weeksy?
Yeah, yeah, I got the fellas down here. Boys, I got Connor Hellebuck and UC Saros. How'd it feel, fellas?
You know, it feels great. We came into this one, we really wanted it. I'm not going to lie.
UC, what about you?
Yeah, Connor was the mastermind. He said hit the twos, and we got the two in the final shot, so... Yeah.
Here's one thing that's so interesting, a little nuance. We have all these fans that are here watching. I love your stick. You're a big man. Your stick, you got a short paddle. Is there a little advantage to having a bit of a shorter paddle for you?
Yeah, I mean, I think it works for me, like moving down on the butterfly and even moving on my feet. So, yeah, it just goes well with me.
And scoring some goals, too.
Yeah, I got to practice a little bit more on that, but happy to get one in.
Congrats, guys.
We head to the beach. Kevin Weeks, PK Subban are at the beach for the Enterprise Splash Shot.
What's up, NHL fans? Weeksy, I'm here with PK Subban.
Yes.
Three-time NHL All-Star.
Part-time model.
What is that?
Part-time model.
Part-time model.
Correct.
Okay, we're here at the rink. This is unbelievable. NHL Fan Fest, Fort Lauderdale.
It's awesome.
Unreal setup. We're here at the site of the Splash Shot presented by Enterprise. Fans are going nuts. It's going to be great.
No, I love it. And the weather's perfect. I mean, look at the turnout here. We got a ton of fans. This is exciting. I think as a player, I would love to participate in this. Weeksy, are you going to get in the dunk tank?
I can't swim. That's all you.
I can't swim either.
That's
so I
him.
Guess both of us are stuck being on the outside. But this should be a fun event. I think the fans will enjoy it.
Here we are, Fort Lauderdale Beach, with some of the best NHLers in the world.
Packed crowd, the best.
Atmosphere.
Brady Kachuk
on the left. Yep. Sidney Crosby, Cale Makar, Adam Fawcett. These are the dunk tanks right here. 5 feet deep.
Freezing cold.
Freezing cold.
I dumped some ice in these tubs earlier. They're chilly.
They are chilly. Here are the matchups. The Rangers go up against the Kachuk brothers, Colorado Avalanche against Sidney Crosby and his buddy, Nate MacKinnon. Let's check out the rules.
In surfing, the goal is to stay on your board and out of the water for as long as possible. Those same rules apply as our All-Stars head to the beach for the Enterprise NHL Splash Shot. Here's how our single elimination tournament works. Two All-Stars team up, going head-to-head against another tandem. As they knock down targets, their teammates sit in dunk tanks. Whomever topples all the targets first sinks their competition and moves on to the next round. Stay dry out there.
First up, New York Rangers. And we've got Adam Fox, PK.
Norris Trophy winner. I like the bucket. This is, to me, this is his event.
I'd agree.
No one sifts pucks better than this guy. And I know he's got the competitive nature, too, so he's going to want to get this done. A little bit of a slow start.
Just
and he's
trying
racing.
To get his feel.
He's trying to set the tone right
There's
now
one.
At the clock.
There's one. He has to get all of the surfboards knocked down and then hit the NHL Shield logo.
Weeksy, what better motivation than Matthew Tkachuk in that dunk tank?
Absolutely.
5 feet of water, freezing cold. Trust me, he wants to see him go down. I'm sure the rest of the guys do too.
One more though. One more.
Oh, there he goes. He got him. And look at Fox. That's the most I've seen out of him. That's the biggest celebration I've ever seen out of him.
Absolutely. Cool as a cucumber. Long Island, New York native Adam Fox, fellow North Trophy winner like yourself. And Adam Fox sets the tone here early.
This guy's a stud too. Unbelievable hockey player.
No question. And you see that accuracy. Pinpoint. There goes Matthew Tkachuk. Let's throw it down to David Amber, who's beachside with the winner, Adam Fox.
Adam, you're a professional hockey player, but how nerve-wracking with, you know, 1,000-plus people watching you do this?
Yeah, a little pressure. I was the first one to go, so I didn't really know what to expect, trying to figure out how to shoot them, and I think got the hang of it once it started going.
And you got that target right at the end pretty quickly.
Yeah, I was struggling early. Like you said, a lot of eyes on you, but, I'm not really a shooter to begin with. So, I got kind of rolling at the end and was able to hit that target.
Down goes Matthew Tkachuk of the Florida Panthers. He's down for a quick dip. David, tell us how refreshing it is for him on an 80-degree day.
Matthew, how cold is that water?
It's kind of more refreshing than cold. I could use it right now. Great weather. Sometimes it feels pretty good, but yeah. Catch you a little bit by surprise.
Lots of Panther fans representing
refreshing.
Down here in South Florida.
Refreshing. I obviously didn't put enough ice in the dunk tank.
And what's the time to be here?
So Brady Tkachuk now, 26.5 seconds. The clock's going to start there and wind its way down. You know what? It's hot out there. He's feeling the sun. He's feeling the heat. But there's also some heat to hit these targets in time to move on to the next round. He's racing against the clock, Brady Tkachuk.
I love that he's rocking Crocs, though, too.
I like the Crocs, but he's racing against the clock. Shesterkin right now, he's got to be a little bit nervous.
He has to be. There's
he's
one.
He's got one down.
There's two.
Two. He's got 12 seconds.
That's three, and he's pulling him. 10 seconds.
Now he's
got to
fire him off. He's got to get him off here quick. I don't know if he's going to have enough time.
He might.
Oh, wait. One more.
Just has to hit the logo now.
One more. Oh, one more shot. Oh, just out of time.
Just out of time.
Shesterkin's got to have a big smile. He gives him the other
one. Well, Shesterkin gets to keep that fresh linen shirt dry for now. Yeah. So the Rangers end up prevailing in this one.
Shesterkin first star. Shocker.
Absolutely. Shocker. There's Brady Tkachuk, who had that opportunity to close it out as he joins David beachside.
You owe your brother dinner now?
Yeah, I know. That one's going to hurt for a little bit. He's going to just be giving it to me all weekend about it.
But talk about how tough this is. I mean, different environment. You're not on the ice. You got a big crowd watching. It's a little different.
Yeah, it didn't help missing the first three. That one hurt the confidence a little bit. But, no, it's great. It's not kind of what I expected at all. It's a great turnout. And, definitely had a little nerves for that.
So the Rangers advance to the final, which sets up the second semifinal.
Yep.
And look who's about to get dunked.
Oh, man.
We got Sidney Crosby, the best player in our generation. Cale Makar, reigning Norris Trophy winner. Stanley Cup champions all around. This should be a great matchup. Sidney Crosby first. Let's see what Mikko does.
There's a look at the big Mikko Rantanen of the Colorado Avalanche, who's having another monster season. And he's pinpoint accurate here so
yes,
far.
Yes, he is. He's moving through them pretty quickly. When you have Sid the Kid sitting in that dunk tank, trust me, you want to get these targets down. Everybody wants to see him going down, including Mikko Rantanen. A lot of bragging rights. He's got one target left. Can
he's
he get it?
Great time here.
He's got to get it under 25. That's the time. Because he gets it. Oh! Sid the Kid.
Yeah, did it. Avalanche fans out in Colorado rejoicing right now as their Mikko Rantanen is able to dunk Sidney Crosby.
CK. Smiles all around. Let's get a look at the replay here. Rantanen knocks out the five surfboards. He's got the final target. Eyeing it. No go.
Yeah.
Gets the last one. Sits in the drink. Loses the hat. He's dunked. But all smiles.
Mikko, 25.5 seconds. That's pretty impressive. What do you make of dunking Sid?
Yeah, I don't know. It was kind of tougher than I thought, but it was. I hope Nate doesn't beat my time, so we can go to the final.
What was that like? You're watching. What were you thinking?
I knew it was trouble. The way he hit those first few, I knew it was only a matter of time. So nice. It was refreshing. Good to get dunked there.
What's your advice, though, for Nathan? Because you guys got to get to the final so you can shoot.
I don't know. Listen, he's going to be in tough. That was a good job there. So I don't know. I don't have much for him. You see my curve? I'm going to have a hard time getting that up. So.
All right. And is a little Avalanche cohort here? Like, you guys seem to be working together, maybe.
Yeah, I think so. It's younger guys against the older guy, Nate. So, it's fun.
All right. Best of luck.
Yeah, thank you.
This all comes down to the stick of Nate McKinnon. His teammate, Kale McCarr, is in the dunk tank right now.
Yeah, Kale McCarr, he's got a long list of accomplishments early in his career. Nathan McKinnon's got 25.5 seconds. Weeksy, I spoke to him before. He wants to knock him into the dunk tank.
This is their opportunity.
This is it, but he's got to move a little bit quicker. He's got to hit those targets just right. He's running out of time.
The final is looming here. The opportunity to make the final. You got to hit these targets, as you said, just right. And it looks as though time is going to be unforgiving.
That's it. That's all she wrote. Not enough time for Nathan McKinnon and Sidney Crosby. They'll be golfing somewhere in Florida on a beautiful beach, 80-degree weather.
Absolutely. Here's a look at the replay. And you can see Nate McKinnon just couldn't hone in that trademark accuracy.
Rattled.
A little bit rattled. Fans of all ages having fun here. Why would they not be?
Beautiful day. Come on down to the beach. You still got time to catch the final, too.
Get involved. And speaking of the final, here it is, Enterprise Flash Shot. Final setup. The Rangers are going through here.
Kachuk gone, Crosby gone. I got McCarr winning this thing. I got him winning.
We'll be back later in the show. And now it's time for the Enterprise Flash Shot final here at Fort Lauderdale Beach.
Yep, it's a big dance week. See Kale McCarr, Igor Shesterkin. This is Kale McCarr's event as far as I'm concerned, facing off against fellow Norris Trophy winner Adam Fox.
And his skill set certainly sets up for this.
He loads up that wrister, Weeksy. He's so fluid with it. You want to hit those surfboards. Well, and he is. He's knocking them down. There's another one down. He's got two more left.
And you've got to hit them just right.
You do. You have to hit them. You know, if you're going to go high, you got to hit them hard. If you're going to go low, you just got to hit them. He's got one more. Oh!
Down goes Adam Fox.
Just like that. Kale McCarr. Let him know what's up. There's the wave. I got this one.
Wow, what a time. 18.7 seconds here for Kale McCarr.
Yeah, and this guy's won everything. He just wins. Oh, boy. How's that feel, Foxy?
Let's head down to David with Kale.
Kale, unofficially, I heard 18.7 seconds. You're putting some pressure on Igor Shesterkin, aren't you?
I mean, I was just trying to rip him as fast as I can. Really, really no routine to that one.
It's official, UMass better than Harvard.
I don't know about that. We had a couple, maybe just one good matchup when I was there. But obviously Harvard's pretty good, too. And Fox, obviously.
Well, when it comes to the splash shot, at least, you got Adam there.
Right now, at least. So we'll see how it happens this weekend.
Igor Shesterkin of the New York Rangers, reigning Vezina Trophy winner, has the opportunity here in the final. I can't emphasize, PK, how difficult this is as a goalie with the goalie stick in this competition.
He can handle the puck. He may not be Mike Smith-esque, but this guy can handle the puck. He's going to hit a few targets, Weeksy. I'm telling you right now. I've seen him shoot the puck. I've seen him handle it. Wouldn't surprise me if he hits them all.
And doing it barefoot, I might add, with the goalie stick, higher degree of difficulty, heavier stick. And he's moving through this with some fluidity.
Oh, he's hitting them, Weeksy. And you know what?
That's three down.
Three down, four
make it
down.
Four.
Oh, can he get one more?
He's got 2 seconds
he's
remaining.
He's out of time. That's it.
He's got five.
So tough for the goaltenders. I can't stress hard enough how hard it is for goaltenders to shoot the puck like that.
Another trophy on the mantle for the Colorado Avalanche. As your winners are Mikko Rantanen and Kale McCarr.
Mikko and Kale, the 2023 Splash Shot champion. Sounds pretty good. And 18.7 seconds. We'll start with you, Kale. What's it like to be the champs?
Yeah, I mean, we tried to come in with a smart strategy here, throw in our big heavy shooter at the beginning, make sure he's sniping him down so we get in the final, and then kind of just try and wing it in the final on my end, and hopefully it ended up working out. So that's all I got.
Mikko, were you nervous at all?
No, I knew Kale's got it. I think he beat my time with 7 seconds, so it tells how good of a guy and a player he is.
All right, so Stanley Cup championship, a Norris Trophy, a Conn Smythe, and now the crowning jewel, the Splash Shot champion.
Yeah, I mean, this one just tops it all, I feel like. There's no debate. This is definitely the one that I was looking forward to, and Mikko and I took it to take the prize today.
Kale, Miko, congratulations. The defending Stanley Cup champs and the Splash Shot champs as well. Congrats, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah. NHL's best 80-degree weather week, see? Perfect recipe.
You nailed it. What a day from the Enterprise Splash Shot Challenge here at Fort Lauderdale Beach.
And it's time to play away. Here's our foursome. Four players going for the title. Nick Suzuki, Clayton Keller, Jason Robertson, and Johnny Gaudreau. And on the tee first is the Montreal captain, the youngest in team history, Nick Suzuki. See what he got, Michael.
He got the coolest gloves of all of them. Well, look at this.
That's clean.
Out the box.
Oh, with roll. On edge.
Oh, don't get too close to the water. Look at. Wow.
You do have to be concerned a bit about the water on this tee shot, so Nick is happy.
It's a nice layup.
So Nick says, nice layup, Michael. Do you think he was trying to drive this par four and one over that dangerous island green?
You hear how disappointed his voice sounds there, but it's into the wind. As a caddy, we're not making birdie from the water. Those pucks don't float.
All right. Up next, Clayton Keller, maybe the best golfer of the four if they were using, you know, golf balls and golf clubs. The 24-year-old grew up in Missouri, and this one's clean as well. Okay, don't forget, the tiebreaker for the competition is the longest drive. So this is an important part of the competition.
Very important, especially after seeing these first two shots. They're in great position.
This is a 140-yard hole we are playing. Drive it just before the water, and then hopefully get your approach on the green. Here's Jason Robertson, the young American from California, having an awesome year for Dallas. Oh, we got a worm burner.
Yell, run.
You don't want to get it too high.
Yeah, wind cheater.
That's what happened. You don't want to get too high, and then it just goes on the ground.
Jason just found out that pucks don't run when they get on grass. He's worried.
Yeah, he's concerned about the approach, but
kind of embarrassed.
Old Nick Suzuki gave him some reassurance there. So our final tee shot from Johnny Gaudreau, Johnny Hockey. See what he got. Oh, nice one. That is clean.
Down the left side.
Pure.
Man.
Not quite as far as Nick, it appears. Boy, that's some clean sauce, Michael.
And he got that up into the air quickly. Off of that hockey stick.
Marinara on that thing.
Yeah. He's my favorite because he's the one I can look in the eye.
Golf clap with hockey gloves.
No one heard it.
So it is Nick Suzuki. He owns the tiebreaker now. Johnny Gaudreau, Clayton Keller, and yes, still away, your boy, Jason Robertson. He's concerned about this approach.
I think the shot's a little further than it looks over the water. You definitely want to get it there, so I think you pretty much got to give it your all. The pins in the right side, keeping it to the left. I think, as you saw before, might roll to the right, so give yourself maybe aim at the edge of the bunker, left of the pin. I think it's going to play a little further than it looks, so give it a rip, and you got your mulligan if
can't
needed.
Can't believe so. I got to go first.
Send it up there.
All right, so there's PGA Tour player Corey Connors, the Canadian who loves hockey.
Yes.
Giving Jason some advice. Can he clear the water?
Oh! He did it! Man, into the wind, just cleared, barely.
He's happy about it.
That almost didn't make it. I thought that was going to be, like, near the pin.
Well, because it died at the beginning.
It looked like it was flying. It looked like it was flying far, but
you're right about how far
it like, big the depth. Depth-wise, it plays longer.
Apparently, hockey pucks are affected by wind just like golf balls are.
You see, it's kind of on edge. It was kind of frisbee into the right.
It's a lot easier than my shot.
And like a bad caddy, you heard one of the players when it was in the air go, go in.
It looks like it was going
to
land
right beside it. Yeah. It died, but I'm still happy with mine.
Okay, so Clayton Keller now with the approach.
I like that little last move at the end. I love it. Bringing it in lower.
It gives him some rhythm. And oh, that's a fortuitous bounce to the right.
How you can spin like that on a puck to go that way?
It's all luck.
What?
You don't know what edge you're going to fall on. Comes in again. This is just perfect. Look at that. Little side sauce. Side sauce. So he's got 20 feet, it looks like, for birdie. Robertson's a good 40-footer for birdie. Let's see what Gaudreau and Suzuki can do.
They switched the pucks. There they took the one away. You can mark it.
Can I be a little jealous of that hair?
The flow, it's gorgeous.
Yeah.
It's luscious. Here's Johnny. eyeing down the flagstick. Oh, he takes it in low and firm, and oh, that's a skipper, but oh, he bounces back.
See, now he was trying, like in golf, to hit that little two hop and stop.
Mm-hmm.
But when you do that with a hockey puck and have that much side spin.
Oh, on the green. I got to shoot mine last first again.
And then here's one hop.
Boom.
Oh, looking for the stop, but
bam. So here comes our long drive. Going last, Nick Suzuki. No problem clearing the water. Now he's thinking to stick this.
Yeah.
Here we
He's in full control. And I love how they can't help but do the little hockey move. That's their waggle.
That is their waggle, correct.
Bringing it in low as
well. He gets a front skip.
Is that closest, too?
I think so.
Look at that look on his face, Michael. He wants this.
You know how much those other golf hockey guys are mad right now?
I want to play in this.
That one hop and stop is exactly what
Gaudreau was looking for.
He
right?
was looking for that same thing and didn't get it.
No. Yeah, look, he's waving to the crowd.
The only righty.
Oh, I'm not back. From this angle, it's even worse.
So now we approach the green for four birdie putts.
Those are four good-looking shots. I want to know which shot was the most nerve-wracking for everyone.
Mine was pretty nerve-wracking. I thought mine was going to be a bit short, but got a nice bounce up there on the green.
Yeah, I'd probably say the second shot, I think, you know, just going over the water, and we didn't really get any practice shots over the water, so just kind of trying to figure that out.
Probably the drive for me. I don't shoot the puck very far, but got a good bounce.
Short guys aren't the longest off the tee.
Yeah.
Robo?
It's got to be mine. I mean, I had to set the tone for the second shot, kind of gauge where it's at. Obviously, it was the worst one, but, I mean, they can thank me for that.
Unfortunately, you get to hear those four words again. You're still away.
Still away.
Still away. Who will be the champion this year? Well, much more from the links and the beach at the 2023 All-Star Skills. Welcome back to the thrilling conclusion of the 2023 Chipotle Pitch and Puck. All the players have reached the green in regulation. Jason Robertson away about 35 feet, Michael.
I would not say this is a good-looking putting setup.
Oh, he goes with a slap shot. Surprising move from the young Californian.
Wrist shot off the tee, slap shot on the green. Look at his face. He knows.
Jason's officially rattled.
Yeah, mercy.
Mercy.
There's no mercy.
He's calling for
what are you calling me for? I got nothing.
Yeah, he wanted to read from
you. Where am I putting here? Where am I aiming?
It looks like it just left of...
Just left a little bit?
Nick's mark, yeah. It should break a little to the right.
All right.
But.
All right.
So Johnny Gaudreau gets last-minute instructions from Corey Connors, PGA Tour player, won the Valero Texas Open back in 2019. Oops. Whoa. Makes contact. Wait, nope. USGA rules. That's fine. It was a practice stroke. Left or right? Goes big.
Now Nick was just watching that. Yeah. Now he got a free read.
Like he's in a scramble. You did that on the tour. You better watch out.
You probably getting a
look at Nick getting
strokes.
A read.
Yeah.
You see his mark right there halfway to the hole.
Yep. That's not good.
So he knows it's left or right now.
Pick it up.
Clayton Keller.
All right.
Another birdie putt about 15 feet, Michael.
I'm going to do my golfer voice here. Okay, on the hill. Should break a little right.
Oh!
Got the lip!
Oh, so close. So close. He thought he had it. Here it is again.
I gave him the read on that and told him right there it's downhill.
Has not tied his shoes. It didn't pay off there. So it all comes down to this, Michael. Nick Suzuki has a chance to be the champion. And if he makes this, he wins not only pride and bragging rights, but free Chipotle for a year. There's a lot on the line.
You know how big I'd be at next year's training camp?
Here it is.
For the bird.
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
Winner, winner, Chipotle dinner. And look at the pride on this young man's face. It's better than the Stanley Cup. He has won the Chipotle pitch and puck contest.
Are we finishing out?
There he is. A wave to the crowd, a win, which includes an interview with our own Michael Collins. Michael, take it away.
Zooks, no one expected a birdie on this par four. We're going to have to start calling you Birdie Man, but you were the one guy who said, hey, after we're done, can I go play golf out there? Did you expect this?
No, I probably wouldn't make a birdie with real golf clubs. So, yeah, I'm just happy that I got a good roll on it. Corey gave me a good read, and you know, I was able to put in the hole.
Which shot meant the most to you?
The putt, for sure. I was a bit nervous. The guys were, it's tough to read the screen, but yeah, I was just tried to put a good roll on it, and broke right in the hole.
Most importantly now, anytime you play any other of your fellow NHL competitors out on the golf course, is this going to now mean you got to give them more strokes?
It might be. It's my first birdie of the year, so we'll take that and try to keep growing my game.
A win's a win. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
108.8, so here we go. Elias Pettersson goes first. And it's a these are tracking pucks they're using, not a radar gun. There's a chip in the puck, and there's sensors around the arena to read the velocity of the shot. And he did crack that 100-mile-per-hour barrier.
Wow. Pettersson's one of those guys that has a sneaky shot. Like, you look at him, he looks slight. You don't think that he would be able to get a lot of power behind it, but as you can see right there, he's able to shoot it just a shade over 100 miles per hour.
Each shooter gets two attempts. Here's Pettersson's second.
Yep.
Whoa.
103.2.
Wow.
Whoa. Wow.
103.2. They play all your light rock favorites, Bush.
Yeah, one of my favorite FM stations. Mm.
Last year's winner was Victor Hedman. Same velocity. Up next, Josh Morrissey having an outstanding year for the Winnipeg Jets. 10 goals. He's got 43 points in 52 games. He's having a career year for the Jets. Ooh, that sounded and looked hard. Chris Chelios, how come you defensemen have an advantage in this competition?
Because all we do is take slap shots.
There you
go.
Way
out there in the blue line. But, yeah, I mean, Friedersen, he, a lot like Doug Wilson, didn't have a real hard swing at the puck, but his timing was great. He had one of the hardest shots throughout my years, too, Doug Wilson. So Peterson kind of reminded me of that. It was pretty smooth.
Yeah, you broke 100 as well in this competition. Do you know when you get it? And what does that feel like?
You know, I watched Peterson's first shot, and I thought he pushed it the other side. And I always felt like if I kept it, you know, with the curve on the left side of the net, for me, it was always harder. So, yeah, you do feel when you catch it right.
So maybe a slight pull.
Exactly, like when you hook a golf ball.
It goes farther, right?
Yeah.
So Morrissey in danger of not advancing. There's the flex on those twigs.
Oh, boy.
What a year this guy's having. Top three Norris Trophy guy in my book. PK, Rasmus Dahlin trying to bring the lumber. Trying to break that 100 mark. 97.9. So Elias Pettersson with 103.2. All right, PK, he's got to get all this one. What do you focus on? Glutes.
Oh, man, he's got to lean into it. He's got to drop that hand down the shaft just like that.
He did.
That looked pretty good.
It did.
I told you.
Good call. You can see it.
I told you.
That's the second hardest so far.
Yep.
PK, how do you warm up for this?
You just eat as much as you can leading up to it. Get as much weight on the body as you can.
That's right up your alley.
That's it.
I saw you smash breakfast yesterday. 9 scrambled eggs.
Six. Six scrambled, but.
All three shooters have improved, PK. Did you tend to feel that was the case?
Well, you know what? The pressure mounts, right? You see a couple guys crack 100. You see a couple guys not crack 100. You just want to make sure you're in the mix.
Seth Jones,
93. Let's just hope that's a tough reading.
Yeah, he's going to have to improve by 10 miles an hour to catch Pettersson.
He's got to drop the hand down.
And everyone's improved on their second shot.
Seth Jones. Got that long stick. He's got to use the torque.
Ooh, that definitely looked better than 93.2.
You know what, Pucci? A key, too, is you got to follow through with your hand low. You got to keep your hand low. Right? That keeps that torque on the stick. Watch Ovi.
All right.
Watch him.
It all comes down to this. He won back in 2018 with a shot of 101.3. That won't do it tonight. So the man 83 goals away from passing Wayne Gretzky. He'll break it February 23rd, 2025, Boosh. That's when he's going to break Wayne's record. on ESPN.
And you're calling, you'll have
this
the call.
Is for
you're
all the calling marbles, it long right? ago.
Here we go.
Snap.
Oh,
oh, the post.
Double post.
That's a tough one. There's no there shouldn't be a reading there.
That does not count.
Exactly.
He hit the 7-10 split. He hits both posts. It has to be a goal to count. So Obi's not even sure
see
how hard
Obi
it was.
Drop, I want to see him drop that hand down. Obi's got to drop down, get his eagle on here. He needs a big shot.
Elias Pettersson nervously looks on. His 103-2 is going to be tough to beat. There he is. Hoping he's the champ. Oh, pound cake. No.
Oh, where is he?
Just 95-1, so.
Elias.
The 12th winner of this contest. And again, a forward rarely wins this. But Pettersson, we began this with that full screen. And PK, give us the winner, PK.
I'm here with the winner of the hardest shot competition, Elias Pettersson. First of all, amazing shot. You had a couple shots it didn't read. How did you feel when you saw 103 up on that board?
Very happy with that. I wanted to beat my the record I have, or the shot I had in St. Louis a couple of years ago.
Well, whatever you're doing, it's working. Is that what was your hardest shot before this one?
It was 102.6, so I just wanted to beat that today, so yeah, very happy with it.
Last question, how do you shoot 103? What's your secret?
I lay all my weight into it, so yeah.
All right, well, it's a lot of weight. Congratulations, Elias Pettersson, hardest shot.
24-year-old Swede. Boy, he remembered his previous fastest time.
Think he wanted it or what?
Clearly. It meant a lot to this fella. He's got 21 goals for the Canucks this year, and the 24-year-old gets it done. Just the fourth forward ever to win the hardest shot competition.
The Toronto Maple Leafs, Mitch Marner.
Hey, PK, we're down in Florida. Did you get me what I wanted?
Of course, Mitchie, man. But, like, get out here, bro.
All right.
Where are
I'm
you?
I'm on my way.
Dude. Mitchie. Come on, man. You know I got you, bro. Dude, it's a big night tonight, man. You know I got you.
I know. We're in Florida, though. You know what I need again.
Bro, Mitchie, relax. I told you I got you, man. I got you. You ready? Check this out. Ladies and gentlemen, Roberto Luongo! All right, guys, listen. Mitchie, no pressure. It's been a while for Lou. No pressure. You guys ready? Lou, let's go. Get in the cage. Mitchie, no pressure, brother. No pressure. You look good in those skates, though, I'll tell you that. All right, let's go up to section 109. Judges, what are your scores? Check the fits, too. Mitchie, we got 6, 10, 15, 21.
Ooh, wow.
Ooh.
Some low numbers there, Bucci.
Some low numbers, but Mitchie,
that's
I like the skate. Back up to you guys.
All right, PK. Boy, hometown hero Roberto Luongo played here two stints in Florida, 11 years total, and I guess they just weren't impressed with this.
Maybe. Yeah, well, maybe because Mitch Marner missed a shot. I think he was supposed to go high glove and maybe allow Luongo to make a windmill glove save like we saw throughout his career night after night.
Crockett and Tubbs would not be impressed with that. So Emily Kaplan, this is a highly controversial situation. Tension is running high. We need some explanation from the judges.
Victoria, you gave him a pretty harsh score. What was going through your mind when you watched that?
I mean, I don't know how to skate, so I did give a 5, but I feel like you got to make a shot, you know. So, but I gave a 5 for the outfit. I kind of like it. I thought it was pretty cool.
What do you like about the outfit specifically?
I mean, it's just something different, something you wouldn't expect to see on ice, right?
What do you think you would do out there if you got the chance?
Me? If I could skate without falling, that would be a pretty good achievement. So,
thank you.
Well, she would have got a forehand top shelf.
Yeah. I mean, look, she said it. Yeah. I didn't put the shot where you're supposed to put the shot.
Of course, a lot of these NHL participants weren't alive when Miami Vice was on from 1984 to 1989.
Sternock. Shot if we're golfing, but it's time to putt, Happy. It's time to putt. Can we get Happy's caddy out here? Where's Happy's caddy? We bring Happy's caddy. Oh, there he is. Come on out, Happy. Happy's caddy. Okay, listen. We got to get you the right club. Here we go. Do we have the puck? Let me set that up. Right. All right, Happy. You got your putt. Oh, it's okay, Happy. Happy, hold on. Happy, hold on. We got to get you your special putter, Happy. Come on. Come on back. We got your special putter. We got Happy's special putter. Give me that putter. There you go, Happy. All right. Try it again. Oh, he wants some noise. Happy wants to hear the crowd. This very putt is for the Tour Championship. Oh! Happy with an amazing putt wins the Tour Championship. All right, guys. Happy, let's see what the judges... Oh, there's the celebration. Judges, what do you got for Happy? 10, 10, 38. Wow, what a score. Let's hear it for Happy Gilmore. Attaboy, Happy. Good job.
Score in the breakaway challenge of 21. They like the concept. Yeah. They like the execution. I think they like the effort of Pasta to give everything to the character.
Terrifically played character, yes, by David Pastrnak. And he awakened the judges as he tells this puck to go to its home. Right in the back of the net. And even when he came out, he kind of skated like Adam Sandler, didn't he? Like Happy Gilmore?
He doesn't play golf. He destroys it.
Yeah.
The 1996 film. And David Pastrnak nailed it to a T. And the judges, again, the judges loved it. He played to the judges.
Yeah.
Like a good performer would. He's a
special moment right now. Amazing All-Star Weekend here in Florida. I want to take this opportunity to introduce to you two of the greatest players to ever lace up their skates. Two of the best players in the game. We've been so honored to have them. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the ice Sidney Crosby and Alexander Ovechkin. Two of the greatest to ever do it. Let's hear it one more time for them. One more time for these two. What an honor and pleasure it is to be with you guys, two of the faces of the league for over two decades now. You guys have gone to war against each other. You guys have beat each other. You guys have tremendous amount of respect for each other. And what people don't understand, as much as you guys battle it out on the ice, you guys have a tremendous amount of admiration for each other. Sid, can you speak to that?
Yeah, obviously we've battled against each other for a long time, so to have an experience like this, share the ice together, be on the same team, share it with the son, it's a lot of fun.
Ovi?
Yeah, we always have fun. We always play for our fans. Obviously, it's a great battle between me and Sid and Caps and Pittsburgh. You know, it's great for hockey.
As a fan of the game, not just a player, it's been an honor to play against both of you. So, but I got an ask. I would really like you both to sign this jersey. Can you guys sign this jersey for me? That's a horrible grab.
Yeah, let's do it like this. Yeah.
Awesome. How jealous is everyone in here?
I think we need one more.
What was that, Sid? What's that?
We need one more signature on this one, I think.
One more signature from who? Oh, Sergei! Sergei! The floor is yours, guys. Sergei, you ready? I think you guys should take a minute and score a nice little goal. What do you guys think? One more time for Sidney Crosby, Alex Ovechkin, and Sergei. One more time. All right, judges, we got 10s across the board. What do we think about that? I love that. Way to go, Sergei. All right, back upstairs to you guys.
You know, the secret weapon in any judging competition is a little child. Sergei Ovechkin won the heart. There's, of course, Alex Ovechkin's wife looking on at her husband and her son. What a great picture moment for that little Sparky, and really for Ovi and Sid as well.
So amazing. And he's like, able to shake and bake and get it through that five-hole Luongo.
Little Kucherov move.
Yeah.
Just let the momentum of the puck go in the net. Kid's got a future.
You know, the one great thing, Bucci, is, you know, you guys play in the National Hockey League, but not everybody has children at the time when they can participate in these events. Sometimes the kids are too small. Maybe they're not the right age. For Ovi to share this with his son is just absolutely fantastic and a great moment for their family.
Emily Kaplan, we got 4 10s up there. I need to know what the judges were thinking.
Guys, you obviously love them as a tandem. You compete as a tandem. So I'm curious, what makes a great tandem?
What makes a great tandem is you always have the leader. The one who scores more. The one who takes initiative. The one who takes them to the promised land to get the goal. To win. That's what I am on my team. And this is what my right-hand man, 100 grand, Joel Dawkins, does. He listens to my lead. I give the lead. He follows the lead. And then we go and we make goals. And we aspire. And we achieve. And we go. And we go. And we go. And we go. And we're going to reach higher. Isn't that right, Dawkins?
You know what's crazy about it? I was reading his mind. To make a great tandem, you got to read each other's minds. Telekinesis going both ways right here. That's what makes us so great. You know what I'm saying? That's what makes everybody out there so great. They can read each other's minds, and they out here scoring, just like your boys, the Street Profits, always do. We score, baby.
All right, so
it's always a better score.
They want the smoke, hey?
Exactly.
Down to Kevin Weeks.
Well, I'm joined by two living legends right now, maybe three living legends, because we have a little one here in Ovi Jr. He's a lefty.
Yeah, I know. But it is what it is. Nothing I can do. I tried.
And he shoots pucks all the time.
Yeah, he is. He's working all the time in the house, skating, shooting, play, watch the games, so watch the highlights. So he's crazy about hockey.
You having a good time? You having fun?
I think yes.
Yes.
See, there you heard it right there. Sid, listen, you might have a younger brother of sorts in Nate, right? That's your boy. That's his boy. Nate's your boy to this point. Now, you taught him well. You were clearly at his Stanley Cup parade last year. How was it?
Yeah, it was awesome.
obviously know how hard he's worked and some of the disappointments he's had in the playoffs. So for him to win and know what he's put into it, pretty special to see everybody in the city be there for him and support him. Yeah, it was great.
You guys are two of the best all time. Keep it going, fellas. Thank you both so much. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Appreciate you. Back up to you, Bucci.
Alex Ovechkin, 83 goals away from breaking Wayne Gretzky's record, and Sergei will be there, I'm sure, to watch it.
Hockey fans, it's time for tonight's exciting conclusion of the Great Clips NHL Breakaway Challenge. Your current leader with a score of 40, Sidney Crosby, Alex Ovechkin, Sergei Ovechkin. And now, getting some help from his brother Brady, please welcome from your Florida Panthers, Matthew Tkachuk.
Where are we going? I've got no clue.
If everybody had an ocean across the USA, then everybody'd be surfing like California. You'd see them wearing their baggies, Huarache sandals too.
Wow. Wow. Well, Matthew Tkachuk, ladies and gentlemen. Matthew, you look like you're feeling pretty comfortable here in Florida. What's All-Star Weekend been like for you and your family?
It's been awesome. I've really enjoyed coming down here to Florida this year. It's been, you know, best thing for me. It's been unbelievable. And getting a chance to represent the hometown team here, it's been amazing.
Well, you've represented it extremely well. Okay, so you got your shot now. What do you need for your shot? Do you need anything?
I need a lifeguard. That would help.
You need a lifeguard? We got a lifeguard? Oh. We got a lifeguard. Do you need anything else?
I'd take a legendary goalie again. That'd be nice.
We got one of those. Legendary goaltender, Mr. Roberto Luongo. All right. You got a couple things out. Do you need anything else?
I'll take a captain of the Miami Dolphins, Christian Wilkins.
We got the captain? Oh, Mr. Wilkins. All right. Do you need anything else? Are you good?
No, I'm ready.
You're ready to go? All right. Put those goggles on. Lifeguard. Hold on. Got to make sure our legendary goaltender is ready to go. Matthew Tkachuk is sporting a beautiful Hawaiian golf shirt button up right now. Trendy 2023 All-Star Bucket Cap. All right. Our goaltender's ready. Maddie's ready. Lifeguard, can I get a whistle, please? Oh! The dexterity, the skill, the talent. Judges, show us what you think. Oh, I see an 11 up there. I see a 2. A 2? Tough, tough judges tonight. Well done, boys. Back upstairs to you guys.
A shocking score. Clearly someone is in the tank for Sergei Ovechkin.
A two.
There, a lot went into that. You have a Hall of Fame goalie. You have the Sasha Barkov.
Listen.
Brady Tkachuk is the ultimate beach bum. Matthew, his dad Keith is in the stands double fisting.
Yeah. This was well thought out. This was well scripted. This was well executed.
And he got the dribble all the way down on the stick. He didn't flub it once.
Exactly.
Threw the puck in the hat and then shot the hat into the net.
But as you say, as he wires that puck home, some people just have a soft spot.
Maybe the styrofoam noodle was too much for that judge. He didn't buy the styrofoam noodle.
Bobby Lou looked like he needed more than a noodle there to save him as he was in the corner.
Disappointing week now for the Tkachuk family, but they've had a good time with Matthew hosting the entire family at his South Florida house. The Honda accuracy shooting. Again, this is a preliminary round. Boosh will crown the champion later, building the drama throughout the evening. Nazem Kadri, career year last year. Rebecca Johnston and Seth Jones will both be passing to Kadri. Rebecca wearing the Calgary sweater. So here comes Nazem, timed. You want to get 4 for 4 as quick as you can in case someone else gets 4 for 4. When Mess did this, there was not a clock. There's two. Now he's got to go shelf for a couple. All right, not terrible.
Nice work.
13.4 to get his 4 targets. Go down the other end of the ice. And oh, Nikita Kucherov. Talk about a guy with pinpoint control. The Greg Maddux of NHL passers.
Yeah, he's a passer. That's, yeah. So, to me, I look at this event, I think Jack Hughes is a guy that I think...
Finish. Olympic gold medalist, NCAA champion, A.J. Malesko, also with us tonight. Between the benches, A.J., as Cooch tries to go to work.
Yeah, you know, it's Hank, look at what he's doing, though. He's doing all right. I agree with you. He is a passer, but any of these guys, come on, look at the skill.
Pat Maroon, your boys can't get these last two.
Yeah, he can. He's struggling here. That's not like Cooch.
There you go.
He found that last one there. He did a nice job picking the corner there.
Does he ever practice in practice doing this? You throw some targets up there for him?
No. I rimmed some pucks to him. He's a big rim guy.
Should make that an event.
Yeah.
How wingers handle rims on the wall.
Best dump-ins, Patty. How about best dump-ins, Patty?
I think I would fare number one in that one. Good placement on the puck.
Yes.
Keep it on the yellow, protecting pucks. I think I would do good in those.
Throwing spirals down there. All right, Panarin now. Artari going to work. There's one. There's two. Ooh. Oh. Lost his rhythm now, chasing that biscuit down. Okay.
That's pretty good recovery after he lost that one pass. I think he didn't came from the different side than he was expecting.
New leader in the clubhouse.
Yeah, you can see pucks coming in alternate sides, and then he ends up getting one from Rebecca Johnston, expecting it the other side. But good on him. Ice in his veins. He keeps it going.
We have 10 shooters. 4 will advance to play and shoot for the title later on in the evening. Brock Nelson played college hockey at North Dakota. Oh, yeah, he can finish. I think he's a sneaky
yeah,
favorite.
Sneaky, yeah.
Oh, just left of the target off the bar.
Ooh, yeah, caught it, right?
That's a goal. He got it. There you go. That's
There's
new
your leader.
Yeah. The New York Islander, nothing boring about that. Huh, Islander fans, your boy can snipe.
Spent the warm-up trying to find Kirill Kaprizov because that's the only person his son wanted to see here. There he is. Good shooting by Brock Nelson.
You know, when you go 2 for 2 right off the hop, I think that kind of settles you down, right? And probably Mess can speak more to that. But Nelson, you could just tell he had like a real calmness to him as he received those pucks.
First all-star experience in his long career. Leon. Ooh, Draisaitl. You'd think he'd be maybe a favorite with that big boat oar stick.
Seriously, look at that blade.
Remember, Pavel Datsyuk had that kind of blade. This is not going well for Leon. Oh, he's not gonna advance.
Looking for the 5-hole there.
Yeah, get me out of here, please.
Yes!
I would walk away at this point.
Back in. Oh, the poor guy. Oh, there we go.
We're all right, Leon. I love Leon. Dry sense of humor. The German, 29 goals this year in 48 games. Former Hart Trophy winner like our Mark Messier. Mess won 2 of them, 1 with the Oilers, 1 with the Rangers. Leon won the scoring title that year in 2020. So here we go. Here's another favorite.
This is the guy that I think is, you know, he's going to win it right here.
Jack Hughes. He's got it all. Young NHL superstar.
Boy, is he scoring goals this year, isn't he?
Mm-hmm. Here he goes, American made. 33 goals this year. 21 years old.
I'm shocked.
Yes.
Oh, no.
He's not going to advance now. We have a top four. So far, it's Kadri, Kucherov, Panarin, and Nelson. Remember, Kucherov has a time in the 18. It would be tough for that to hold. So Jack will not advance to the final four, Weeksy.
Jack's been awesome all year long, too. I expect him to be a little quicker there, but he's right up there in my Hart Trophy candidates right now. Patty, what's Jack Hughes has been unreal, and he's also a Florida-born player.
He is. Jack's been a great, great player all year. He's been showing his skill, and that's why he's been, you know, scoring goals at elite, you know, and, you know, he just proved it there, but he struggled there for second there, but he figured it out.
Your son's playing in a tournament here, too, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He is. So he's down here right now on the bench with me, and this is the closest thing he'll see with me at an All-Star game.
Is that right? Three Stanley Cup rings, you're right.
Slow start for Vlad Tarasenko. He won't have that sweater on for long. He'll be traded before the March 3 deadline. But the Blue, he's not going to advance either to the Final Four. We'll have three left. Kevin Hayes, Alexander Barkov, Sasha, and then Connor McDavid will go last in the accuracy shooting.
Think of the appreciation you have for guys that have gone 4-for-4
absolutely right
in the past. These are some great players that are going 25 seconds plus to complete the targets.
OFD, originally from Dorchester. Kevin Hayes experiencing NHL All-Star Weekend. He mentioned how his late brother Jimmy wanted to see him at an All-Star game sometime. Kevin was just a great player as a young kid. Looked up to his big brother Jimmy, and you know he's thinking about him this weekend. Come on, Kevin. If he can get these last two, he's got a chance. Boy, Kucherov is still alive.
If he hit that.
Yeah, he needed 18.1. So there it is.
Good showing, though.
Not bad, yeah.
So representing the Flyers right there.
Absolutely, Boosh. Yeah.
So Nikita Kucherov's 18.1 is still hanging around.
How about that, huh?
But you got two of the best in the game. Two of the best hockey players in the world as Kucherov hopes his time can stand. But I don't know. With Barkov and McDavid to go, I think one of them will beat 18.1.
You know how calm Nelson was? I think Barkov's in the same ilk as Nelson.
Cool as a cucumber. But he is home. He can hear the hometown crowd. Let's see if he can beat 18.1.
There's one.
Oh, yeah. He's going to do it. Did he get that one? He's got to go 2-for-2 now.
He's got it.
He's
got
to get this. He's got to get this.
Oh,
he knew it too. So Kucherov still survives.
There it is.
So here we go. We're last shooter. Connor McDavid needs to beat 18.1 to replace Kucherov in the final four with Nelson, Panarin, and Kadri.
NHL's leading goal scorer, Connor McDavid, I might add, too. He's been shooting the lights out so far up in Edmonton this season.
Never won a Rocket Richard Trophy. This could be the year. David Pastrnak is on his heels. So Kucherov looks on with fellow Russian Arturi Panarin to see if Connor McDavid can beat 18.147. This should
be
easy.
Thanks for coming.
Oh, how
here
about
thanks
going
for coming.
Four.
Take care.
Yeah!
Thanks for coming. Take care.
Woo!
Thanks for coming. Take care.
He beat last year's winner, Sebastian Aho, who also went 4-for-4. He went 10.9. But that is impressive.
How good is that?
9.4. Daniel Sedin once hit 4 in a row and 8.9.
And that's exactly why he's been the best goal scorer in the league so far this year. Watch this laser-guided accuracy here.
41 goals in his 50 games this year. And Kucherov knows, I'm toast. I am toast.
Good night.
Yeah, and there's the rise.
Best part of this, too.
We have it all.
As great of a player as he is, he went into the offseason trying to get better. For a lot of young girls and boys that are watching, even the best player on the planet tried to get better.
A fun night, and we're going to culminate with the accuracy shooting. We have four participants left, Boosh.
Yep.
We'll go one-on-one against each other. Then those two winners will move on to the final.
And in the first round, we saw McDavid do it with ease. The question will be, can he do that once again.
Gotta
here
reload.
Now you're gonna redo it. And nothing matters before. You gotta find a way to do it once again.
Pat Maroon, what's your sense from these final four?
What's up, guys? I missed you.
Yeah, what's your sense here as we get ready for the accuracy shooting semifinal and then final?
I need to see the lineup so I know, and I'll give you my order.
All right, well, you got McDavid, Nelson, Panarin, and Kadri left. You think Connor will finish it off?
I think Connor's got it. He was pretty hot there.
Going for his first Rocket Richard. And talk to your boy, another Missouri fellow Clayton Keller.
Yeah, I got Clayton Keller right next to me, a good fellow St. Louis kid. Love watching him grow up and now be a star in Arizona. How's this experience been for you?
Yeah, it's been awesome. It's a lot of fun here. Obviously, election night for me did, you know, the event a couple days ago. So just relaxing, enjoying, and watching everyone put on a good show.
Who do you like in this last event? Who do you got? Do you think McDavid's pulling it off, or do you like Brock Nelson? What do we got?
I think McDavid for sure. I mean, he made it look pretty easy the first time, but I don't know. I think it's up in the air.
All right. Back to you, Booch.
Good stuff, Pat Maroon. All right. So let's introduce once again the final four in the accuracy shooting championship.
It's time to decide the winner of the Honda NHL Accuracy Shooting. So let's get to the matchups. In the first semifinal, Brock Nelson faces Artemi Panarin. And in the second semifinal, Connor McDavid goes shot for shot with Nazem Kadri. South Florida, make some noise. Here we go.
So a little different here for the semifinal. We're going to shoot simultaneously, Boosh, and the nets are side by side. So close proximity. Not quite the normal shooting background they're going to see. The blue paint won't be in front of the net.
Right. And listen, you know, when the other guy on the side of you, you see them start to pick off some targets.
Sense
it. The anxiety starts to raise in the shooter, and something a little bit different to deal with here.
Only one passer now for the semifinals, and two elite defensemen, Carlson and Dahlin. So it's Carlson to Brock Nelson. I think Brock Nelson, if I had to pick one, I think he might pull this
off.
Like no pressure on him,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
First all-star experience.
He looked smooth in that first round.
He did. He was money. He'll go up against, though, Artemi Panarin. So one righty and one lefty. Kind of eyeball to eyeball. Panarin has got two down. Both shooters going cold. Nelson needs this. He got it. So Nelson beats Panarin. Gets his fourth before Artemi does.
Well, like I said, I think that there's like an element of seeing the other person go at the same time. You know, how do you react to that, right? It's not the normal system that we have in the first round, so.
This is so good. Now look at this. Coming up, Edmonton-Calgary. Battle of Alberta.
Here we go.
Shooting accuracy semifinal. So they'll warm up the mitts, play catch with their passers. Kadri from Carlson and McDavid and Dahlin playing some catch so Connor can warm up those hands.
It'd be a huge upset if Kadri could win this. You know, especially with the way McDavid performed in that opening round.
I was going to say, we just had the Rangers-Islanders and now we got the Battle of Alberta, so this is set up quite well.
Good call, AJ. Kadri was 4 seconds slower to get here. This is obviously a side-by-side shooting. Unlike the last one, where you had one righty, one lefty, Kadri would be looking at McDavid. McDavid can't see Kadri.
That's the key. Turn your back to people, right?
Would you feel a little pressure there, AJ?
Yeah.
This close together?
Yes, definitely. But you also look, McDavid, he's got peripheral vision. He knows exactly which ones are hit, even if he can't see Kadri.
McDavid hasn't missed yet. 6 for 6 going back to the last round. 7 for 7. Finish it, Connor. Take your time. Boom.
Oh.
Mick Jesus.
McNasty, Mickey Mouse, whatever you want.
Did Kadri beat him? The clock?
I think Kadri beat him.
Unbelievable. Everyone focused on McDavid.
Yeah.
And once again, 91.
Connor was like dusting that last one off a little bit. He had to stick handle it a couple times.
And it cost him. Look at 91. One,
two.
Got a piece of that. Actually, he missed that one, but he's shooting quicker than McDavid.
Right there.
And
right
boom,
there.
He beat him by a half a second.
It is that stick handle, Boosh. You're right.
Don't dust it off, AJ.
I think, you know what? It's
Boosh is livid.
You were talking about how he couldn't see him. He thought he hit the three, right? He thought he had some time. He took a stick handle, and I'm not sure he realized that Kadri nicked one of those, so he thought he was down two.
Wow.
Kadri will stay
out guys.
There. What's up?
Subinator down here on the ice.
Yeah, what's up, PK?
I think they should trade McDavid after that. I really do.
Yeah, it may happen. Kenny Holland.
They should move him.
Kenny Holland might do a 1-for-7 trade. All right,
I'm sorry,
here's the final.
Jesus.
Yes, Brock Nelson versus Nazem Kadri. Hold on, we're not ready yet, boys. So Nelson, 29 of the Islanders. Kadri, 91, here we go. Nelson off to a good start. Oh, Nelson's 2-for-2. He's got time, he's got to get it now. There we go, Brock Nelson one shot away. Who said the New York Islanders are boring?
John Buchagross did.
Brock Nelson.
First one to win on the left side.
College hockey pride. Nelson having a career year for the Islanders. Really an underrated center iceman. Absolute sharpshooter, PK Subban.
All right, I'm here with the sharpshooter, Brock Nelson. Brock, you got your four kids here, your family here. What does it mean to win the sniper competition and beat out McDavid?
Yeah, that was fun. It was a good competition. Like you said, it's fun to have the family here. I think they're enjoying it and having a great time, and just happy to be here.
Congratulations, dude. Keep shooting.
War Road in the house. Brock Nelson of the Islanders. His team will fight for a playoff spot, and now he can go home an accuracy shooting champion forever. Been a fun night here in South Florida. Don't forget the game is tomorrow, Lees. We're looking forward to that as well as Connor McDavid goes home disappointed.